How's it going, everyone? I'm Jason. Welcome back to the channel. This is the K2B from KickPi. If you haven't heard of KickPi, they make Android TV boxes. KickPi has a partnership with Tanix, and you can purchase many of their products on Amazon and AliExpress. The K2B comes with Android pre-installed, but with no Google services. I'm not an Android TV user, but when KickPi reached out, I told them, sure, I'll have a look at the K2B. I like the K2B's design. I was also curious about how it compares to a Raspberry Pi. I'll talk more about that in a second. You should know that this board is for developers. Development is not my avenue. However, I enjoy trying single board computers. So let's have a look at it. The all-winner H618 powers the KickPi K2B. This quad-core Cortex A53 processor can clock up to 2 GHz. The GPU is a Mali G31 MP2. RAM ranges from 1 GB to 4 GB of DDR4. You have 8, 16, and 32 GB of eMMC storage options. There is a USB Type-C port for power, two USB 2.0 ports, a reset and power button, GPIO pins, a single full-size HDMI port, and Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. You also get an SD card slot and an infrared receiver. As I mentioned earlier, the K2B comes pre-installed with Android 12. You can also install KickPi's custom image of Ubuntu 22.04, which runs the lightweight desktop environment XFCE. Regular tasks like web browsing, creating documents, and video streaming via YouTube work fine on the K2B. However, depending on your hardware specs, you may face some limitations. The K2B uses an older Cortex A53 chip, similar to the Raspberry Pi 3B. While Raspberry Pi boards benefit from extensive software and community support, the K2B has several advantages. It's energy efficient, the I/O layout facilitates easier cable management, and it's affordable, just under $30. The KickPi K2B is for developers and those who enjoy tinkering with hardware. It's excellent for digital signage and embedded projects. However, it's not intended for casual users. It's a solid board for its purpose. Just remember, this is a development board, not a consumer gadget. If you want to try the K2B for yourself, links will be in the description box. And if you already have the K2B, please share your thoughts in the comments. Thanks again to KickPi for sending us the K2B for this video. And if you want to see more single board computer content, subscribe to the channel. I'm Jason, and I will see you in the next video.